So with that, we have completed the administrative part of the DNC Act 10 rules. Now we are going to look at the provisions of the DNC Act 10 rules, which are applicable to the import of drugs, the manufacture of drugs, sale of drugs, and labeling and packaging is considered as a separate activity under the provisions of the DNC Act 10 rules. So as we move ahead, we will look at the application of DNC Act to import, manufacture, sales, and labeling and packaging of drugs. Any drug that is imported into the country, whether it is a bulk drug or whether it is a finished dosage form, has to comply with the provisions that are laid down in the DNC Act 10 rules, and the import should be done as per the procedure that is given in the DNC Act 10 rules. So let us look at the procedure for import of drugs. An application for an import license, the very first activity to be carried out is to apply for an import license. No drug or cosmetic can be imported into the country without the appropriate import license. Therefore, the first rule is, the first step is, application for import license shall be made to the licensing authority in form number 8 for drugs except the drugs that are specified in schedule X and form 8A for drugs specified in schedule X, either by the manufacturer or license. So if a pharma company wants to import a drug, it can do so by first filing an application. The application is form 8 if the drug is other than schedule X and form 8A for drugs specified in schedule X. Once applied, once application reaches the licensing authorities, then if everything is found okay, then an import license will be issued in form 10. And that is required, form 10 is required for import of drugs other than schedule X, and import license in form 10A is necessary for import of drugs specified in schedule X. Application for import license in form 8 or 8A shall be accompanied by a copy of the registration certificate. What is this registration certificate? An application for issue of registration certificate shall be made to the licensing authority in form 40, either directly by the manufacturer, that I mean importer, or his agent. The applicant shall pay the testing fees directly to the testing laboratory approved by the central government. And what are these testing fees? As we saw, any drug that is imported into the country, a sample of that is taken by the drug inspector and first sent for evaluation and analysis to the central or the state drug control laboratory, for which the importer has to pay for the testing fees. Single application may be made and a single license may be issued for import of more than one drug manufactured by the same manufacturer in one factory. So form 8 or 8A is used for applying for license to import for drugs that are manufactured in any one location outside the country. A single application may be made and a single registration certificate issued for import of more than one drug manufactured by the same manufacturer in one factory. So let us say there are some drugs that are being manufactured in Vietnam in one location. If some pharmaceutical organization wants to import the drugs, he has to make a single application. However, if the drugs are being manufactured in three different locations in Vietnam, then the manufacturer has to apply in form 8 or 8A in triplicate. Three different forms for application and three different forms for license. So each location, one license. That is the rule. What are the conditions to be fulfilled by the licensee? licensee. Now remember, what is the purpose of the license? Application for the license is to import the drug into the country. Now there may be some specific requirements for that drug to be imported. So the licensee has to comply with those requirements. So the licensee must have adequate facility for storage of the drug, imported drug, such that the properties of the drug are preserved. The licensee, upon once application goes, must allow an inspector to inspect the premises and check the records. Licensee must furnish the sample to the authority. Licensee must not sell the imported drug from which the sample is withdrawn, and is advised not to sell, and if he has done so, then recall the batch from the market. Now remember, it may so happen that the importer imports the drug even before he gets the license. In special cases, this is done. However, he is allowed to import it into the country. However, he is not allowed to sell it till his license comes in hand. So form 10 or 10A is in hand, right? So he should have, when he does so, he should have the facility for storage, so that such that the drug does not, cosmetic does not degrade. He should allow an inspector to inspect these premises. He should also give a sample to the inspector for testing or analysis. And he should not sell. If he has already sold it in the market, the imported drug or cosmetic in the market, he may be asked to recall it from the market. The licensee shall, on being informed by the licensing authority that the imported substance does not conform to the standards of strength, quality and purity, withdraw the remainder of the batch from sale. If he has already sold it in the market, or if he has or if the imported goods have gone to the retailer, and then it is the government analyst report says that the quality is not up to the mark, purity is not up to the mark, then he is asked to withdraw the batch. Licensee or the importer must maintain a record of the sale showing the particulars of the substance sold, of the persons to whom the imported drug or cosmetic is sold. These records shall be available for inspection by any drug inspector. Okay. Record keeping is very, very important aspect of the pharmaceutical industry. Here too, when an importer wishes to import a drug, he has to maintain certain records. So, the licensee or the importer should maintain a record in which the following data should be available: name of the drug or cosmetic, batch number, name and address of the parent manufacturer, the date on which transaction was completed, opening stock on business day. So suppose today is day one, what is the stock on day one? What is the quantity of drug received and the source? Name of the purchaser, that is to whom the drug or cosmetic has been sold, his address, his license number, the balance quantity of drug at the end of the business day, and signature of the responsible person. Thus, on obtaining the license, import license, and during the course of regular business, on a day-to-day basis, all this data has to be entered, the records have to be created, preserved, and should be available to the drug inspector as and when he wishes to inspect the records. So, what is the duration of import license? Application for the license has gone in form 8 or 8A. The license has been obtained in form 10 or 10A. What is the expiry? What is the duration of that import license? A license, unless suspended or cancelled, so if everything is fine, shall be valid for a period of 3 years from the date of issue. And provided that application for fresh license is made 3 months before expiry of existing license, then the current license shall be deemed to continue. So the first license will be that is given is for a period of 3 years. if there are some problems or discrepancies, the same may be cancelled or suspended. However, if everything is fine, all rules and regulations are being complied with, and the inspection does not throw up any non-conformity, then the license expires at the end of 3 years. However, it is necessary to apply for the re-license, fresh license, 3 months before expiry of the existing license. So there were two requirements for import of drugs. One was the import license and the other was the registration certificate. So registration certificate, unless suspended or cancelled, is valid for a period of 3 years from the date of issue. If manufacturer fails to comply with any of the conditions of import license, then the licensing authority may suspend or cancel the license. There are some drugs for which you cannot even apply for import. And what are those classes of drugs that are prohibited to employ to import? Is misbranded drugs. Go back to my talk on what are misbranded drugs, okay, and refresh your memory. Drugs which are substandard in some way, drugs that are claiming to cure diseases specified in Schedule J. Now, what are those we will look at when we go to Schedule J? Adulterated drugs, spurious drugs, drugs whose manufacture, sale, distribution is prohibited in its original country. However, such drugs may be imported for the purpose of examination, test and analysis. Also, patent and proprietary medicines whose true formula is not disclosed. So, there is a prohibition on import of certain drugs. Therefore, anyone who tries to apply for import of such drugs, it will be a waste of time. And what are these drugs for which the import is prohibited? These are misbranded drugs, adulterated drugs, spurious drugs, substandard drugs, drugs that claim to cure diseases which cannot be cured, that is Schedule J, drugs whose manufacture, sale and distribution is banned in the country in which it is manufactured, and those drugs whose composition is not known, that is patent and proprietary drugs. We learned that application for drugs belonging to Schedule X is in Form 8A and license is obtained in Form 10A. So what are the Schedule X drugs? These Schedule X drugs are narcotic and psychotropic drugs. I am sure you know the meaning of the word narcotic and psychotropic drugs. Now, if these drugs fall under Schedule X, that means they are controlled drugs. And if an importer wishes to import these drugs, then there are certain conditions to be fulfilled. Okay, so what are those conditions to be fulfilled wherein the importer wishes to apply in Form 8A? Let us look at the conditions. Licensee must have adequate storage facility. The licensee or applicant must be reputable. The license granted before should not have been suspended or cancelled. So if the applicant has previously applied for import of drugs belonging to Schedule X, but for some reasons and some problems that license has been suspended or cancelled, then he cannot reapply for a fresh import license. The licensee should not have been convicted under of any offence under the DNC Act or the Narcotic and Psychotropic Drug Substances Act. It is very important that the importer is a person who has a very good reputation, who has not been banned or imprisoned or fined earlier in connection with drugs belonging to Schedule X. Only then he can apply for license to import in Form 8A and obtain the license upon fulfilling these conditions. That was as far as drugs imported into the country for the purpose of treatment or cure, manufacture or sale. Now, certain categories of drugs are allowed to be imported into the country not for sale but for the sole purpose of examination, test or analysis. For the import of such drugs, the license should be obtained in Form 11, and the imported drugs imported under Form 11 should be used only for that purpose of ETA, examination, test or analysis. All records with respect to the quantity, the name of the manufacturer, the date of import, etc. should be maintained and should be available for inspection. And the organization, the importer must allow an inspector to check the premises and inspect the premises and check all records of such drugs. Drugs are permitted to be imported for personal use by individuals provided it is a part of the passenger's luggage and for his exclusive use. The drug must be bona fide for personal use, so a doctor's prescription, the importer, that is the individual, must keep a doctor's prescription with him. The drug must be declared to the customs if so directed. And the quantity that a person can carry at one time is not more than 100 average doses. Small quantities of the drug may be imported for treatment of patients suffering from life-threatening diseases or diseases causing permanent disability by the medical officer of government hospitals or medical institutions. However, the drug should be such a drug that is imported only by government hospital for treating specific patients should be approved in the country of its origin where it is manufactured, and the drug that is imported should be used exclusively for treatment of the patient for that condition. The government hospital should allow the inspector to inspect their premises. The hospital should maintain records and submit half yearly report. And the drug should be stored under proper storage conditions and should be dispensed by the registered pharmacist. So we have had a brief overview of the import of drugs, the licenses, the forms in which application is made, and the form in which licenses are procured to import the drugs. Drugs may be imported with the purpose to manufacture or sale, or drugs may be imported for personal use, or drugs may be imported by institutions, government institutions and hospitals, or drugs may be imported solely for the purpose of ETA, that is examination, test and analysis. So there are procedures for applying for import license, getting the import license as well as getting the registration certificate. So two documents are important in connection with import of drugs. That is the registration certificate and the import license. Now we come to the next important point, that is the penalties that are levied if the conditions that are given in DNC Act and rules are not complied with. Here you can see that if the offense committed by the importer is import of spurious or adulterated drug or a drug which involves risk to human beings or animals, or drug that does not have any therapeutic value, then in such a case the penalty is, if the drug inspector evaluates, inspects and finds that the importer has carried out these offenses, any of these offenses, then the penalty is 3 years imprisonment and 5,000 rupees fine on the first conviction, subsequently 5 years imprisonment or 1,000 rupees fine or both. And any other and not complying with any other provisions of the DNC Act and the conditions that are laid down in the import license, in such a case the importer has to undergo 6 months imprisonment or 500 rupees fine or both the first time, subsequently 1 year imprisonment or 1,000 rupees fine for each subsequent offense committed in contravention of the provisions of the import license as well as the DNC Act and rules. Moving forward, so with this we have completed the provisions of the DNC Act and rules to the import of drugs. Moving forward, in my next slide, I have summarized the forms for application and import license, and I will revise them with you once again. As you can see, if the drug to be imported belongs to Schedule C or C1, then the application should be made in Form 8. Whereas if the drug is to be imported is to belonging to Schedule X, application should be made in Form 8A. The licenses will be obtained in Form 10 and 10A respectively. If drug is to be imported for ETA, then application has to be made in Form 12. License will be given by the licensing authority in Form 11. If the drug is to be imported for personal use, remember not more than 100 doses, the application is Form 12A and the license will be issued in Form 12B. If the drug is imported by government hospital or any other medical institution for treatment of specific patients, then the import application is made in Form 12AA and the license is obtained in Form 11A. With this, we have completed the very important topic of import of drugs and provisions under the DNC Act and the requirements of the import license authorities. Just as there are some conditions and regulations for the import of drug, similar regulations exist for the import of cosmetics. For more details about the regulations, you can refer to the DNC Act. Here, I just wish to point out that the cosmetics that cannot be imported, cosmetics that are banned from being imported are those which are misbranded or spurious or containing harmful ingredients. Also, those cosmetics which are not of a standard quality cannot be imported into India. Those cosmetics which are found to have a content of more than 2 parts per million of arsenic, more than 20 parts per million of lead and more than 100 ppm of heavy metals cannot be imported into the country as per the laws. Thus, there are regulations existing in the DNC Act and rules which govern the import of drugs and also cosmetics.